So you're using an InDesign template and you want to take it from ordinary to extraordinary in a few simple steps. How can you take it from beginner to pro? Hi, my name is Laura Kyung for Envato Tats Plus, and in this video, I will show you how to elevate an InDesign template using simple InDesign principles and other design concepts. In this video, I will also be referencing one of our courses called The Principles of Design. So be sure to check it out, available for free on the YouTube channel if you want to know more about the topic. So let's get started. Pre-designed templates are a great way to save time. They're cost-effective and most of the time easy to customize. These pre-made templates help ensure your design looks professional from the get-go. Most of the time, these already have the right print settings and the design is already decided, especially where certain elements are placed. While InDesign layout templates come in a wide variety of designs, you still want to customize them a little bit because using templates means that other designers are also using them. So you want to make it less template-y and give it your own flavor. So in the next few lessons, we will take a look at what specific steps you can take for specific mediums to make these InDesign templates less ordinary. Let's start with a business card. So a business card is the gateway to knowing someone, and first impressions are important. So when you're working with a business card, there are a few key things that you need to consider, like size, shape, including only the necessary information. Choose a template that already goes with your brand personality. So using a full image, it's not the best decision because of the real estate that we're working with. So let's take a look at this template. In this case, I want to create a tattoo shop business card. Something clean will do the trick. So let's head on over to InDesign and select one of the templates. So let's take advantage of the real estate to create impact and keep it minimalist and highly contrasting by using only black and white. So here I want to get rid of all the elements, only leaving this text box, and let's create emphasis by using a different font for the business name. We can use this same font on the front of the card for later. So by getting rid of all the other elements, I can play more with the white space to create something memorable. White space doesn't mean only white space, but also a play with the negative and the positive space. In this case, let's move the name of the business all the way down to the bottom right. Simple, impactful, and clean. For the front side of the card, I want the background to be black. So let's extend this. Let's change the color on this. Let's get rid of this element that I won't need. I want to align this to the very right and change the font. So this supporting text will create more balance against the other two lines of text on the left side, and change the point size by 1 point. So there's more contrast between these two text boxes and the name. Let's change this to semi-bold just to create some texture. Let's get rid of this line. And I want to change the name to the same font as we use on the back of the card. Words. Let's change the title to match the other text.
This whole process is called typesetting, and typesetting is when you go into the design and finesse all of the details. So typesetting is important because that means it is attention to detail, and attention to detail elevates the design. Let's talk about flyers. So flyers are a great way to let people know about an event. In this case, I want to create an acoustic festival flyer. And for this, it's important that we have a high quality image that is the right resolution if we want to elevate the design. So let's head over to Envato Elements and browse their library until we find the perfect image. So here we're looking for something that fits the theme and that is also high resolution. Let's use the rule of thirds, and this is important in any design. We can achieve a sense of organization. Let's create some guides here, 3x3 and 0 on the gutter. Let's get rid of this main graphic and add our guitar image. And we can see that the elements are already placed within the rule of thirds, but now we have an image that we need to work around. Let's adjust the image to a position that we like. Let's move the elements to where the rule of thirds are positioned. So let's move the date here so it can be more legible. And the social media handle under the title so it is more like one unit. And now all we have to do is customize it with our own fonts. So in flyer design, hierarchy is key to let the audience know what information is most important. Hierarchy is achieved through contrasting elements, size, color, placement. So in this case, we want the name of the festival to pop, so we can choose a different font and a larger point size. So again, typesetting is important here. We need to choose the right typefaces, two that go together, no more than that. And just pay attention to the little details, like size, tracking, kerning, line space, and making sure that all the text boxes match the fonts that we chose. We want things to look cohesive, that make sense. And we already did so much by changing just a few things.
So the template helped us figure out the text boxes on the flyer. And to elevate it, we added a high resolution image and we moved the text boxes a little bit around so it wouldn't look too template-y. And that's how we have now an impactful flyer design. So what happens when you have to consider more than one or two pages? In this case, we have a trifold brochure where you have to consider 6 different panels. So things get a little bit trickier because you have to consider variety, rhythm, and movement.
So rhythm dictates how our eyes move across a page and how we consume content. We can then draw emphasis to specific information. Here we have a few elements on the cover that we'll then repeat throughout the interior pages. We will use the same font here. Let's change the content to a botany design course. And I want the color to match to something more natural. So I already have a couple of swatches saved. And here we can also go deleting elements that we don't think are as important or take away from the design. As we open the cover, the next panel the user sees is one of the exterior. In this case, it is a good idea to give the viewer a visual, no text, so their eyes can have a bit of a break. Variety is important as not every panel has to be exactly the same. So I decided to use a high quality image from Elements that goes with the theme. And we can add and adjust the image. So after seeing this panel, the user will look at the inside of the brochure. The second and third panels of the interior are similar but different. And that's the goal for this brochure. I want to change the background and make sure that we match the color swatches to the outside. Again, everything is in the details. I want to make this panel different just so it stands out from the other two. I'm going to change the background to dark. And make sure that I am repeating elements that are being used on the other panels or the outside just to create balance and repetition. And movement will help the user's eye move from element to element. A little typesetting. And again, keep in mind that here we're trying to achieve a good sense of rhythm, variety, and movement, key design principles. Well, the third panel includes a couple of the visual elements used in the other panels to create movement and an image to fill up some of the space to add a visual interest. Again, high quality images are important to make a brochure or really any piece of design looking the best. And last but not least, the users will look at the middle panel from the exterior. This is the back of the brochure. So to achieve cohesiveness, we can repeat the dark background from the panel on the inside and adjust the information. And again, let's make sure that we're using the other panels as a guide to build this one so it all matches together.
So we took a simple template and we customized it and elevated it with high quality images. We moved a couple of text boxes around and applied key design principles like rhythm, variety, and movement. In this video, we edited three design templates with similar tips and other tips that are more specific to those mediums. So let's round up some of the tips we learned. Use design principles to enhance the design and make it custom. This is a basic tip, but so important. The design depends on these key principles like rule of thirds, positive, negative space, emphasis, rhythm. So check out the design principles course to learn more about these essential concepts. Use high quality images. They truly make the difference in making a design piece feel premium. If you're looking for high resolution images, be sure to check out Envato Elements. They have an extensive library with millions of assets. Typesetting is attention to detail and therefore premium. This includes choosing a font that's suitable, unique, and legible. Fonts can also show personality and reinforce a message. So if you want to learn more about the nitty-gritty of typesetting, be sure to check out the Ultimate Guide to Typography course. It's available for free on the YouTube channel. And last but not least, adjust to your own brand colors. Nothing is more evident in a brand than their brand language, and color is an important one. This is the fastest emotional connection you will make with the audience, so be sure to use it to your advantage. Using these essential tips will take your InDesign templates from ordinary to extraordinary. There's nothing wrong with using InDesign templates, but I believe it is necessary to add your own flair and use your own perspective on the design by moving text boxes around and using high quality images to elevate your design and stand out from the crowd.
You can find some of the assets used in this video at Envato Elements. Be sure to check out their creative assets library with unlimited downloads, and don't forget to subscribe to the Envato Tech Plus channel for more videos.
My name is Laura Kyung, and from all of us at Envato Tech Plus, thank you for watching and we'll see you next time.